Good day to all of you. I am Dr. Arvind Sharma, Associate Professor in Physics, Government Dugar College, Bikar. Today we are continuing the topic trapped diodes. In last video, we understand about its physical structure and principle operation. Today, I again repeat some few important parts of its physical structure and principle of operation, because it is a very important topic for you and not so easy to understand and remember easily. First of all, what is the TRAPED stands for? Trapped plasma avalanche triggered transit mode. Trapped plasma avalanche triggered transit mode. TRA for trapped, P for plasma, A for avalanche, T for triggered, and T for transit. Hence, TRAPED stands for trapped plasma avalanche triggered transit mode. Typically, high peak power diodes have silicon. Silicon is the material which is used, and the structure is like N plus P, P plus N, N plus. N plus P, P plus, or P plus N, N plus. Okay? Principle of operation. Approximately analytic solution for the trapped mode is in P plus NN plus diodes have been developed by chlorpheniramine et al. Investigated the P plus NN plus trapped diodes analytic solutions, and D. Loach is the other scientist. Okay, these analyses have been shown that a high field avalanche zone propagates. What they show? They show that high field avalanche zone propagates through the diode. High field avalanche zones are propagated through the diode and fills the depletion layer with a dense plasma of electrons and holes. What happens from this? Fills the depletion layer with dense plasma of electrons and holes that becomes trapped in the low field region behind the zone. A typical voltage waveform for the trapped mode of an avalanche P plus NN plus diode operating with an assumed square wave current. What we are assuming? Square wave current drive. Okay, you can see here square wave current drive P plus NN plus, and here the curve between time and voltage and current. The rotate curve shows current, and the bold curve A, B, C, D, E, F, G, A, G to A. Again, the same point. What is A? A is the same point. So A to Z, this curve is for voltage. What we see from A to B, charging. B to C, plasma formation. C to D, plasma extraction. C to D, D to E. C to D and D to E. D to E, plasma extraction, and E to F, E2F is residual extraction, and again E2Z charge, and G is the equivalent to A, and voltage and then constant up to A. Okay. So the main theme of here, a typical voltage waveform for tripid is shown in the figure, where avalanche P plus NN plus diode operating with assumed square wave current drive is shown. At point A, electric field is uniform throughout the circuit. And its magnitude is large, but less than the value required to avalanche breakdown. Electric field value is constant at A and value is high, but it is not sufficient for avalanche breakdown. The current density is expressed by Z equal to epsilon S d upon it. What is epsilon S? Semiconductor dielectric permittivity of the diode. What is epsilon S? Semiconductor dielectric permittivity of the diode. Okay. And here the operation showing operation is shown in the statement forms which we already understood in the previous lecture. Now come to here. At a point Z, the diode current goes to zero. For a half period, and the voltage remains constant at VA until the current comes back on and the cycle repeats. The electric field can be expressed as EXT equal to EM minus QN AX upon epsilon S plus ZT upon epsilon S. What is NA? NA is nothing but doping concentration of the energy. What is capital NA? Doping concentration of the N region, and X is the distance. Thus the value of T at which the electric field reaches EN. The value of T at which electric field becomes EM at a given distance X into the depletion region is obtained by setting EXT equal to EM. Yielding EXT equal to EM, boundary condition T equal to Q NA upon JX. Differentiation of equation 3, what is VX DX upon DT? Vx dx upon dt equal to z upon qn. Vx is the avalanche zone velocity. What is Vx? Avalanche zone velocity. Here is a small example for avalanche zone velocity. A tripid diode. The values of NA and Z are given. The values of doping concentration and current density for a tripid diode is given. And calculate the avalanche zone velocity, which is a simple formula Z upon QNA. And you can easily calculate. Thus the avalanche zone or avalanche shock front. Avalanche zone or avalanche shock front will quickly sweep across most of the diode, leaving the diode filled by a highly conducting plasma of holes and electrons whose space charge depresses the voltage to low values. A very important physical explanation is given here. What happens? avalanche zone will quickly sweep across most of the dam. Avalanche zone is quickly sweeps across the diode. And what is leaving behind? Diode filled by highly conducting plasma. Diode filled by the highly conducting plasma of holes and electrons. And the space charge developed from these plasma of holes and electrons depresses the voltage to low. Because of the dependence of drift velocity on the field, we know that drift velocity depends upon the field. The electrons and holes will drift at velocities determined by the low field mobilities. Now, low field, according to that, the drift velocity of electrons and holes. And the transit time of the carriers can become much longer than. What is rho now? L upon Vs. And what is Vs? Vs is saturated carrier drift velocity. What is Vs? Saturated carrier drift velocity. Thus, the tripate mode can be operated at comparatively low frequencies. Since the discharge time of the plasma, that is rate Q upon I of its charge to its current, can considerably greater than the nominal transit time of the diode at high field. Therefore, the tripate mode is still a transit time mode in real sense. What is tripate mode? Transit time. That the time delay of carriers in transit, that is the time between injection and collection. Time delay of carriers in transit. Time delay in the carrier's transit. That is time between injection and collection is utilized to obtain a current phase shift favorable for oscillation. Current phase shift favorable for oscillation. Power output and efficiency. RF power is delivered by the diode to an external load when the diode is placed in a proper circuit. RF power is delivered by the diode. RF power is delivered by the diode to an external load when the diode is placed in a proper circuit with a load. The main function of this circuit is to match the diode effective negative resistance to the load at output frequency while reactively terminating tripping frequencies above the oscillation frequency in order to ensure tripate operation. To date, the highest pulse power 1.2 kilowatt has been obtained at 1.1 gigahertz, 5 diodes in series in this reference paper, and the highest efficiency of 79% has been achieved at 0.6 hertz in this paper. Table 8.31 shows the current state of diodes, tripate diodes, that is given in paper, this paper. Here, frequency, peak power, average power, operating voltage and efficiency are compared in different papers which scientists reported or investigated. Okay, frequency from 0.5 gigahertz to 8 gigahertz, peak power from 600 to 50, frequency is increasing, power is decreasing, average power also not symmetrically decreasing, there is difference, operating voltage is decreasing, efficiency is also decreasing. The tripate operation is a rather complicated means of oscillation. However, the requires good control of both device and circuit properties. In addition, the tripate mode generally exhibits a considerably high noise figure. Tripate mode has generally high noise figure compared equal to the input direct. Thus, upper operating frequency appears to be practically limited to below the millimeter wave region. If we are going towards the upper operating frequencies, these are practically limited to below the millimeter wave region. So, we completed trapped diode also, its physical structure, its principle of operation, power and efficiency. So try to understand trapped diode. Okay, thanks to